Hello students and welcome to Supporting Learners. So in this video we are going to start chapter 8 of class 11 biology. So we are going to start with the very first topic, which is cell introduction and discovery. Now we will start the introduction by asking a very simple question, that what is a cell? Now in your junior classes you must have studied that cell is the smallest unit of life, and also that cells are often called the building blocks of life. Now we will understand the meaning of these two statements by the help of a very simple example. Now what we see here is a very big building. But what is this big building actually made up of? Yes, this big building is made up of small bricks. So many bricks, they are actually joined together in a particular way in order to make this building. So we can say that this brick is the smallest unit of this big building, and this brick is the building block of the building. Similarly, in all the living organisms, all the plants and the animals, the smallest unit is the cell. Cell is the building block of life, that is all the living organisms. Also, cell is called the fundamental structural and functional unit of life. Now what do we mean by this? Now cells, in the body of living organisms, cells, they group together to form tissues. Tissues group together to form organs. Organs group together to form organ systems. And organ systems combine to form a whole organism. So we can say that in the living organism, the smallest unit is the cell. Cell is the fundamental structural unit of living organisms, and this cell performs all the functions that are necessary for the living organism. So cell is also known as the functional unit of life. So we can say that the body of all living organisms is made up of cells, and cell is the basic or the fundamental structural and functional unit of life. Now let's talk about the discovery of cells. How were cells discovered and who discovered the cells? So cell was discovered by a scientist called Robert Hooke. So Robert Hooke discovered the cells in the year 1665. Now Robert Hooke, how did he discover the cells? Because there were no microscopes at that point of time. Today we have very sophisticated microscopes, and most of the cells, they are actually microscopic. You cannot see them with the naked eye, and there were no sophisticated microscopes available. So how did Robert Hooke discover the cells, and what was he observing? So he was actually examining a thin slice of cork, and he saw that the cork resembled the structure of a honeycomb consisting of many little compartments. He made a chance discovery through his self-designed microscope. So as I said, that there were no sophisticated microscopes available like they are today. So he designed his own microscope. And under this microscope, he observed a thin slice of cork. Now what is a cork? Cork is the outer bark of the tree. This part of the plant is called the cork. And you must have seen this in the bottles. The wine bottles especially, they are sealed or closed by the help of this cork, right? So he observed a very thin slice of this cork. He kept it under his microscope, and what did he see? He saw that the cork actually resembled the structure of a honeycomb. Honeycomb is honeycomb, madhumakhi ka chhatta jisko aap bolte ho. So he basically saw that it was resembling a structure of a honeycomb, and there were many little compartments, very tiny tiny compartments, boxes actually. So he observed this, and he called these boxes cellulae. He called these boxes cellulae, and now today they are called cells, but it was named cellulae by Robert Hooke. What does cell mean? Cell is a Latin word which means little rooms, right? So Robert Hooke is also known as the father of cytology. Cytology is the study of cells, and Robert Hooke is the father of that. So this is a picture of Robert Hooke. Now what Robert Hooke observed was actually the dead cells. Dead plant cells. Cork is actually the dead part of the plant, and he observed the dead cells under the microscope. And Hooke's description of these cells was published in Micrographia. Now, Micrographia is a book, very famous scientific book, which gives the description of all that Robert Hooke observed under the microscope. The cell observed by Hooke gave no indication of the nucleus and other organelles found in most living organisms. So basically what Hooke observed was just empty boxes, right? They were just empty boxes and they had a cell wall because they were plant cells, right? So this was what he observed. They were actually empty boxes. Because the cork Hooke was observing was dead, the cells he observed were also non-functioning. So there was no nucleus, no organelles, and these cells were dead cells. So they were actually non-functioning. Now next came Anton von Leeuwenhoek, with improved microscopes discovered free living cells in pond water for the first time. So Anton von Leeuwenhoek, he was a Dutch scientist. He was actually not a scientist in the first place. He was actually working in a textile shop. He was actually a craftsman. So he used to inspect the quality of the cloth, for which he used the magnifying glasses to inspect the quality of the fabrics. This is the picture of Anton von Leeuwenhoek. So he was actually, you know, he used magnifying glasses, but he was actually unhappy with the lenses that he was using. So he created very high quality, you know, tiny spheres that could actually magnify the objects up to several hundred times. And he was a very, very curious man. He was a very curious man. He, with those lenses, he basically observed whatever he could get his hands on. So he basically observed the pond water and he discovered the living cells. What was known to Robert Hooke was dead cells. Anton von Leeuwenhoek actually discovered the living cells. Under what? Under pond water. His most important discovery was the existence of a single cell organism. While using a microscope to examine pond water in 1674, he observed dozens of protists which he called animalcules, as well as spirogyra or green algae. So as I said that, you know, this man was a very curious man. He used to observe, you know, things around him in his microscope. So what he observed was actually single-celled organisms like bacteria, and he also observed protists, and he named those organisms animalcules. Animalcules means animal-like structures. So what we know today as today we call them bacteria or protists or you know, algae, but at that time these terms were not there. He named those organisms that he was observing as animalcules, right? And this is his microscope. He designed about 500 microscopes. And so he is also known as the father of microscopy and also the father of microbiology. Why? Because it was due to Anton von Leeuwenhoek that we could actually see single-celled organisms for the first time. And he also observed many cells like blood cells, spermatozoa, and he could also observe the blood flow in the capillaries. So it was all, you know, just due to his curious nature. He was not actually a scientist, a well-taught scientist. He was a self-taught man in science and also the master microscope maker. So he wrote actually a lot of letters to Royal Society of London for what he used to observe. He wrote letters, lot of letters he wrote to the Royal Society of London. Now after the discovery of the cell, the nucleus was discovered many years later by Robert Brown. So this is the picture of Robert Brown. And Purkinje in 1839 coined the term protoplasm for the fluid substance present in the cell. So protoplasm is a colorless material, you know, of the cell consisting of the cytoplasm, the nucleus and the organelles. So this term protoplasm was coined by Purkinje. This is also asked in many exams. Now let's solve some previous year questions to test the knowledge that we have gained, and these questions are being asked in medical tests in the previous years. First question, cell was discovered by, these are the four options. You can write your answer in the comment box. Pause the video and write the answer in the comment box. Cell was discovered by C. Robert Hooke in 1665. Question number 2. The first man to observe a live cell under microscope was? These are the four options. Yes, it was discovered by B. Leeuwenhoek, Anton von Leeuwenhoek. Third question. He placed a slice of cork under his microscope and he called the structure observed as cell. The person mentioned is? Yes, the answer is A. Robert Hooke. Question number 4. Which of the following was first examined under a microscope that later led to the discovery of cells? A. Honeycomb, B. Cork, C. Drosophila and D. Dead leaves. Yes, the answer is cork. A thin slice of cork was observed and it looked like honeycomb, but it was not the honeycomb that was observed. The structure observed was the cork. Question 5. Robert Hooke published the discovery of the cell in his book. These are the four options. The answer is C. Micrographia. Question 6. Who was the first person to describe the various forms of bacteria? A. Robert Hooke, B. Sheldon and Schwann, C. Anton von Leeuwenhoek and D. Peter. So yes, the answer is very right, C. Anton von Leeuwenhoek. Question 7. Robert Hooke's observation of honeycomb-like structural units under microscope was actually A. Plant protoplasm, B. Plasma membrane, C. Cell wall and D. Entire cell. So yes, Robert Hooke just discovered the dead cells. So the answer is C. Cell wall. Question 8. Nucleus was discovered by? Very direct question. The answer is yes. C. Robert Brown. Robert Brown discovered the nucleus. Question 9. Which scientist was a Dutch craftsman who developed the first compound microscope? Dutch craftsman discovered the first compound microscope. It was Anton von Leeuwenhoek. Answer is A. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video useful, hit the like button and subscribe to Supporting Learners and also hit the bell icon so that you're notified every time a new video is released on Supporting Learners.